are starting off 2021 the right way, looking back on all the fun moments that we've had in our eKids Online videos in 2020. So join us each week as we find all the funny, silly, laughing moments that we had for the past few months, and join us as we laugh along with them. And we'll see you later.
Bye! Bye.
Welcome back, eKids Masked Singer fans. We're back with our esteemed judges, Lauren and Jordan. And we're so happy you're here because we are about to reveal the dancing dinosaur. Let's see who's behind that mask. And here's the reveal. Wow, the dancing dinosaur was Carlos Gomez, our youth pastor? I am blown away. He did such a fantastic job. What a performance and what a surprise.
Whoa. Okay, that's a good one.
Carlos, really good. Oh man, that was outstanding.
Wow, eKids Masked Singer fans, I'm still reeling from that reveal, but I cannot wait to meet our newest masked singer, Wonder Woman. You're gonna love this performance. Stay tuned after the so-and-so show.
You never turn away, you never leave my side. And every time I call your name out just to find that you're already right here with me, never been alone. I can trust you with my heart, 'cause this I know. You are always faithful, you love me from the start. No matter what I'm facing, I will trust you with my heart. Trust you with my heart. There are days when I feel I need a friend, and then I hear your voice reminding me again that you're already right here with me, never been alone. I can trust you with my heart, 'cause this I know. You are always faithful, you love me from the start. Trust you with my heart. You are more than able to lead me through the dark. Your love is never failing. I will trust you with my heart. Whoa, I will trust you with my heart. No matter what may come, no matter what I go through, God, you are never gonna fail me. I will trust you with my heart. No matter what may come, no matter what I go through, God, you are never gonna fail me. I will trust you with my heart. You are always faithful, you love me from the start. No matter what I'm facing, I will trust you with my heart. You are more than able to lead me through the dark. Your love is never failing, I will trust you with my heart. You with my heart. Whoa, I will trust you with my heart. Whoa, I will trust you with my heart.
Ooh, what you got there, Lawson?
Ooh, it's a new board game. I just got it. It's huge in Latvia.
Cool.
You want to play?
Do I?
All right, it's pretty straightforward. So you start by choosing a token, right? Now, the green token has a different power than the orange one because green token has the ability to roll again every single time you roll a four. Now, the orange player can only carry one antique at a time. Each antique has a special, unique ability. You get to add one move to your turn unless you roll a prime number. So, next up, the red token right here gives you the power to scapegoat one other person. Now, the blue token gives you the ability to carry water. Now, to start the game, you need to roll two ones. Right. So now, we already mentioned a couple different regions of the board, like the Prairie of Inexplicable Darkness and the Desert of Forgotten Dreams, but there's also the Sea of Our Desalinated Tears and the Echo Chamber of Our Lesser Angels. Now, you can move by rolling the dice, drawing a card. Now, are you ready to play? Here we go. Oh, so close. All right, your turn. Hello, everyone. I'm Steven.
And I'm Lawson. And welcome to the So-and-So Show. Steven, you know what? I was thinking we should play a game.
Let's do it.
But I'm all out of games.
Oh.
So please welcome someone who knows stuff. Woohoo!
Come in, come in.
All right, take a seat. Here we go.
Boom.
Papa squat.
All right.
Right there. All right.
Thank you. I'm a little nervous. I'm not usually on camera. This is all very exciting.
Yes. So why don't you tell us who you are and what you know?
Well, I'm Sebastian Longfellow, and I design board games.
Wow! Can you tell us about some of the games you've designed?
Oh, sure. I have a brand new game I'm working on where the goal is to move all four of your pieces from your home pad to the center, but it has special goals, like you can set up a blockade with two of your pieces, and you can roll again if you roll doubles.
So, like, Parcheesi?
I never heard of it.
It's a pretty popular game.
Huh.
So what other ideas you got there in that notebook?
Oh, this one's really creative. Mm-hmm. It's on a special board with a numbered grid with different chips on it. Your opponent has to call out the different coordinates, and if they hit where your ship is placed, it's a hit. Your goal is to sink all of your opponent's ships.
Oh, Battleship.
Yeah.
No, I call it Sink a Ship.
But it's like Battleship.
Very similar.
That's a game?
Yeah.
Okay.
What else?
Yeah. Well, this one has five dice. And
oh, Yahtzee!
This one. You make words from different letter tiles, and you put them together.
That's Scrabble. I think that's where you're going.
Okay,
with that.
Well, this one can be played anywhere. It's a 3x3 grid, and you make X's and O's, and then
tic-tac-toe. With the 3x3. That's tic-tac-toe.
Someone is stealing my ideas.
Hey, it's okay. Don't worry about it. Clearly, you've got a talent for coming up with board game ideas. You just have to come up with an idea that no one's ever tried before. So, you know, let's come up with a theme.
Yeah.
What is a good theme for a board game?
Clowns.
Okay, yeah, clowns.
Clowns!
Sure. So, okay, you come up with a clear goal for the clowns. What's a good, kind of like a theme that they have to, a goal that they have to work towards? Let's say they have
fit
to...
Fit 10 of their friends in a car.
Yes.
Okay.
Exactly.
Yes.
Okay.
Perfect.
I actually like that. That's special. There's a simple and direct goal everyone is trying to accomplish.
Yes.
And then you would layer in different objectives and you know, obstacles like an escaped lion, a heckling child, or banana peels of varying sizes.
Now you've got it.
Yeah.
Okay. Wait. Has anybody made that game yet?
I don't know. No, but it sounds
let
fun.
Let me go and make it before someone else does and steals my idea. Oh. Sebastian Longfellow out.
Good luck.
Bye, buddy. Fun with your clowns.
I'd play that game.
Do you want to invent it before he does?
Stop.
Okay, sorry.
It's Bible story time with Kellen. Kellen.
What's up, guys?
Not much. What do you got for us today?
Well, I got a parable that Jesus told from the book of Matthew. Now, Jesus would often teach using stories called parables that showed a bigger truth about God or the world.
Perfect. Take it away.
Sure thing. And here to help me today are the So-and-So Show players.
Okay. Why?
Jesus talked about an important person who was going on a journey, and we'll call her... the boss.
Yeah! I'm going on a journey! Oh. But I have so many bags of gold. What should I do with them? I have an idea. A marvelous idea! I give the bags of gold to my servants, and I let them take care of it. the boss. I'm going on a long journey.
Oh.
And I'm trusting you to take care of these 5 bags of gold.
Me?
Absolutely.
You want me to be in charge of these 5 bags of gold?
I'm trusting you to take good care of them.
Thank you.
Patricia!
Yes, the boss?
I'm going on a long journey, and I'm putting you in charge of these 2 bags of gold.
Me?
Exactly.
You want me to be in charge of these 2 bags of gold? Your fortune, your wealth.
I trust you to take good care of them.
Yes! Of course.
Blanche!
Yes. Yes, boss.
I'm going on a long journey, and I want you...
Yes?
...to be...
Yes.
...in charge
yes.
of...
Yes!
...in charge of this 1 bag of gold.
Me?
Yes. I trust you to take good care of it. And now, I'm off!
What am I supposed to do with this?
Time passed, and the boss came back from her long journey.
Let's see what happened to my fortune. Sonia!
The boss, you left me in charge of these 5 bags of gold.
And?
And I took it and turned it into these 5 bags.
You've been faithful with a few things. I'll put you in charge of many things. Share in my happiness.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Patricia!
Boss, you trusted me with 2 bags of gold, and I turn it into 2 more bags of gold.
You've been faithful with a few things. I will put you in charge of many things!
Yes!
Come, share in my happiness!
Thank you.
Thank you.
This is so good.
Blanche?
Hey, the boss. And you're pretty, you know, you're tough, so I was scared of this responsibility, so I took your gold and I buried it in the dirt. I kept it safe. So here's your 1 bag of gold.
You knew I was tough, and you did nothing with my money? But you could have put it in a bank. At least you just let it sit there in the ground doing nothing. Yeah. Sonia!
Yes.
Here. You're in charge of this bag of gold, too. What are you doing?
Dancing.
You could have shared in my happiness, but you chose not to do anything with what you were given. You missed out. Outside. Go. Keep going. Further.
Is this far enough?
Further.
Okay, thank you for this opportunity.
Patricia! Let's party!
The end.
Great story, Kellen.
Yeah, I learned a lot. Like, maybe I shouldn't have buried that bag of bicentennial quarters my Aunt Matilda gave me.
Maybe not. But remember, a parable is more than just a story. There's a deeper meaning.
So it's not just about burying money?
No. I think the story teaches us that God has given us so much. Now, maybe he hasn't given us money or bags of gold, but he has given us talent and creativity and energy and strength. And we can use what God has given us to tell others about him or to show God's love. We shouldn't keep the gifts God has given us to ourselves. They're meant to be shared.
That's great. Thanks, Kellen.
No doubt. I'll see you guys later.
Later. Bye, Kellen.
Great story.
Yeah, and it helped us learn another rule of life. Make the most of what you've been given.
That's a good rule.
Sure is. Hey, will you call me the boss?
Absolutely not.
Okay, then. Reveal the question!
How can you use what you've been given?
Right, because we've all been given something.
Talent, intelligence, love.
This shovel. Bags of bicentennial quarters.
That too. Talk about it with each other. How can you use what you've been given? And we'll see you next time on
The So-and-So Show!
Got it.
Side angle so you guys at home can see it.
Do it. That's not 20.
I got him!
That's like 10.
I got him!
Me too!
I'm gonna catch yours, you catch my...
Okay.
I can't even put it on my arm.
So I'm gonna go that way, you go this way.
I'm gonna go to my right, your left.
Okay.
And you go to your north, southwest degrees.
Okay.
And go, one, two, three. Did you
get it?
Wow.
Welcome back, E-Kids Masked Singer fans. Here she is. Wonder Woman.
Hopped off the plane at LAX with a dream in my cardigan. Welcome to the land of fame, excess. Quote, am I gonna fit in? Jumped in the cab, here I am for the first time. Look to my right and see the Hollywood sign. This is all so crazy. Everything seems so famous. My time is turning, I'm feeling kind of homesick. Too much pressure and I'm nervous. This afternoon, turn on the radio. It's a party in the USA. Yeah. It's a party in the USA.
What a performance. Amazing. Judges, tell us, what did you think about her performance?
I love that song. And she did a pretty good job with it, too. But it just sounds so...
familiar.
Yeah.
I'm perplexed. And, well... yeah, it was quite a performance.
It was great.
I'm just really confused.
It was super. Get it, Wonder Woman? Super?
Wonderful.
Well, I have my ideas about who Wonder Woman could be, but judges, what are your guesses?
Well, I'm pretty sure that I know that voice. It just seems so familiar to me, and I've been watching a lot of our E-Kids preschool show, and I'm pretty sure maybe this is why it's so familiar. I think it's my friend Diana.
Really?
Yeah, I mean, maybe.
It could be, but I'm actually kind of worried about this one. I don't know if I can even share my answer. It just is so eerily familiar. I gotta pass. I can't even share my answer on this one.
Well, you have to share.
I can't do it.
You have to give him, he has to give a guess.
Secret ballot.
No.
There's some debate about who she could be. I think we should go ahead and reveal her right now. Wonder Woman, take off that mask. It was Anne Roth? I am blown away. She was amazing. Who knew she had those kind of moves? That was fantastic. I'm so surprised. Judges?